These are their chosen representatives.
Very well. Let us hear what they have to say.
Yes, sir! I present to you our commander, Lord Quintus Vancina, Legatus of the First Legion.
The First? I had no idea you had survived.
We lost our emperor, our city, more than half our troops. For my wounds, I may never take the field again. But we survived, aye. In a manner much to your liking, I dare say.
We have no intention of adding to your misfortunes, nor do we bear you any ill will.
Spare me. Though you children may speak in earnest, overtures of peace ever ring hollow in my ears. So long as man stands to profit from his neighbor's suffering, war is inevitable. Driven from our ancestral homeland into this blasted waste, yet still you yearned to rob us of our paltry scraps. 'Twas only with Magitek that you learned to keep your distance. Though we knew it was only a matter of time before you regrouped and returned. Conquest and empire were our only defenses. Emperors Solus and Varys understood this, and through their campaigns saw us grow and prosper. Much blood has been spilled in Garlemald's name, aye. But if it is a choice between yours and mine, then it is hardly a choice at all.
I do not deny that a great many conflicts throughout history were driven by the desire or necessity to gain by another's loss. That is not why we are here. Nor have we come to petition your aid in the war with the Teleferoi, grave though that threat may be. Our purpose is simply this. We wish to help you. Let us help you. If there is aught that can be done to ease your plight, we would be glad to do it.
Perhaps you would. But regardless of the ideals you espouse, your leaders would not send an army into Garlemald if they did not stand to benefit. If we accept their aid, they will expect their efforts to be rewarded once the Teleferoi are no longer a threat. And after compensation and concessions, the great empire would be brought to heel. Her enemies rejoice at her downfall. Our third eye, a mark of shame.
We won't stand idly by and let your people be humiliated. And we're not alone in that. We only want to make a difference, to make this world of ours better. Surely you can understand that. What I'm trying to say is, there are so many people who just don't care about making you suffer. And maybe that's almost insulting after all the suffering you feel the world has subjected your people to, but believe it or not, that's the truth. And now we're here, and all we're asking is for you to tell us what you want, what you hope for.
So much blood has been shed, so much lost. All because of this endless war. Who wouldn't want to end it? Can we not work together to face our problems as one?
Answer me this, young peacemakers. If a world without conflict is your desire, why reject the unity and prosperity of Garlemald? Is it because we do not share your faith? That we do not share your heritage? That our ideals and virtues differ? That we cherish and hold in the highest that which you do not? Disparity is the root of discord, and peace built on compromise is flawed and fleeting. Happiness for one and all is a dream, and the reality is that to the victor go the spoils. That is why we Garleans will never submit nor surrender. For freedom and for pride, we will remain true to ourselves until the bitter end. That is my hope. It seems there is nothing more to say on the matter. You will remain here while I decide what is to be done with you. Do not be alarmed. No harm will come to you if you cooperate.
We will not resist. However, as your guests, I ask that we be allowed to speak with the other members of your group.
As you wish. I had no intention of locking you up, as by dawn you would be frozen stiff and you're no good to me dead. You are free to move about the encampment, but there is one condition. Collar them.
What are these?
Incentive. You'll be watched at all times. Stray too far or act suspiciously, and we will administer a rather painful shock. Stop. Keep away from that one. The champion of Eorzea is not so easily cowed. Even if she allowed herself to be collared, the shock would be no more than an itch. No. If she refuses to obey, we will activate the twins' restraints instead.
You needn't worry about us.
We'll forget we're even wearing them soon enough.
Even now, you still... Why go to such lengths? What is it all for? You are a curious one. A far cry from the merciless barbarian others paint you to be. You will be their warden. Take them away.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Finally escaped the watchful gaze of your keepers, have we? Don't react. You'll only draw attention to yourself. Just carry on as you are and listen. After you left with the Garlean lad, Lucia bade a few of our scouts follow you at a discreet distance. We observed you being led into the station, but decided against venturing inside. When you emerged sometime later, and we saw that the twins were sporting Magitek collars, it was clear what had taken place. Now, as quietly as you can, tell me everything.
The Legatus himself, eh? Now there's a surprise.
This is also the first I've heard of a plan to join forces with the Tenth and storm the Tower of Babel. An interesting development, and perhaps the opportunity we've been waiting for. Our comrades back at the camp also received some rather promising news, but it's still too early to get our hopes up. For now, keeping yourselves out of harm's way comes before all else. Whatever demands the Garleans make, indulge them. With luck, this will all be over soon. Until then.
They had not gone far.
We searched high and low, but no luck, I'm afraid. I might have guessed you'd be the only one to find anything.
I wasn't expecting much to begin with. Eventually, there will be nothing left out here for us to safely salvage. For now, this will have to suffice. We should return to the station.
Ah, there you are. Heard you'd gone hunting for ceruleum above ground. Brought back a king's ransom?
Hardly. But thanks to these three, we have enough to last a little while longer.
Well, well. It's not at all as I was expecting, these ones. For savages, they seem positively docile. It's a poor attempt at humour. In all honesty, I'm grateful for your efforts. But even with another night of warmth, there are those among us who may not live to see the morrow.
I trust your expedition was fruitful.
Lord Quintus!
Use what you procured to refuel the armor.
But, sir, what about the heaters for the camp?
The time for action is upon us. My men and I have matters to discuss. In the meantime, you are to wait here. Do not forget, you are being watched.
The time for action. What did he mean by that?
I can only speculate. Clearly something requiring their magitech, given what we just heard. Whether they plan to utilize it now or after they join with the 10th is another question. Will they ever escape this cold? Return to and reclaim the idyllic spaces of which Eulus spoke?
Finished your war, Council?
Alfino and Alizea to stay here. As our prisoners. They will be released once your comrades have relinquished their supplies and withdrawn from Garlean soil. Until our terms are met, they will be detained at a separate location.
After everything we've said and done, this is how you treat us.
Our allies have but limited supplies. They may stave off cold and starvation for a short while, but what then?
For now, keeping yourselves out of harm's way comes before all else. Whatever demands the Garleans make, indulge them.
Get them out of here.